Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you 10 useful examples of using cell formatting in Numbers. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now, I'm often asked questions about how to do something in Numbers using either formulas or perhaps conditional highlighting. However, often the answer is to use neither of those, but instead use cell formatting to solve the problem. So it's important to understand how cell formatting works and how you can create custom cell formatting in Numbers to get the most out of it. Let me show you some practical examples. So first, let's say you have a column of numbers here and they represent something in units, like, for instance, distance, like meters. So you may have the column heading, distance, and then in parentheses put meters. You see this a lot, but it's not always convenient to have the unit right there in the column head. Instead, you may want to have it right here. But if you typed, say, 10 m, that's minutes, and 10 meters, well, that will be thought of as a piece of text, not a number. So instead, you just want to have the regular number here, like this. But when you do that, now it's not clear what unit this is in. So let's select all of these cells. I'm going to double click on the letter here at the top of the column. So I select all of the cells, but not including the header cells. Now I can go to Format Cell, and under that there's Data Format, and it's set to Automatic. What we want to do is create a custom format. Let's click here and then go to Create Custom Format, and then we'll call our custom format Meters. And then we're going to have here the standard number. We can click on that to get some extra things like the separator, in this case a comma, and if we want a minimum number of digits, we'll just leave all this as default now. And it shows us an example right here, 45, using this last number. We also want decimals here. So I'm going to drag this up. So now we can see it says 45.3. We could go in and add and remove digits if we want for these decimals. Now we want this to be shown as meters. So we'll just type some text here. I'm going to add a space, and then I could type M for meters or type out the entire word. You could see the example here. So now when I hit OK, you can see everything shown in meters. If I select the cell there, you can see the actual value is just 10, just the number 10, or just the number 45.3, but it's going to display with the word meters after it. Now another question I've gotten in the past is how do you have the sign in front of a number? For instance, if I have 10 there and then negative 12 and then another number like that, I get a sign before the negative number, but nothing before the positive number. Usually that's fine. But if you want to put a plus in front of the number, you could do that with a custom format as well. So now I'm going to go to Data Format here and create a custom format. And I'm going to call this one Always Include Sign. I'm going to leave it as type number. Use the standard format here. I'm not dealing with decimals in the cases of these numbers, so I'm not worried about adding the decimal set. But what I'm going to do is add a rule. And the rule is if the number is greater than 0, then do the same thing, except before it, I'm going to put the plus symbol. So now you could see here in the example, plus 30. So I'll hit OK, and you can see I get pluses in front of any number greater than 0. I get the minus, that's already included on any negative number. And if I include a 0, it's not going to do anything. Now another request I've had in the past is to represent zeros as blanks. Sometimes you get a data set that has lots of zeros and only has numbers where that number applies. So you want to have the number 0 there. That's got to be the value. But you don't want it to show 0. You just want it to be blank. So we can create a custom data format for that. Call it blank 0. And we'll use the standard format here. Maybe let's add decimals just in case we want to have a decimal number there. Let's add a rule and say if it's equal to 0, then display nothing at all. Now we can see we get that. If I select the cell, you can see the actual value is 0, but the display is showing nothing. We can also edit that custom format and have it be something else. So maybe instead of 0, we can do 2 dashes like that. Now you can see 2 dashes are put there anytime the value is 0. You can also use these conditions to check for a value range. So for instance, say I've got a set of values here, but anything over 100 or below 0 isn't valid. So I want to indicate that here instead of showing the number. So what I can do is create a custom format, and in that format I will add a rule and say if it's less than 0, then display something like too low. And add another rule and say if it's greater than 100, then also put something like that. So now you can see too low and too high are displayed whenever the value is too low or too high. If I change this one to 101, you can see it changes to that. The value is still there. It's just displaying now as this instead of the number. Now sometimes you have large numbers like these, and instead of displaying all the zeros, you want to use little abbreviations like K or M to represent thousands or millions. You can do that using a custom format as well. So create custom format. Let's just call this one K. And you see I've got the number there just as before, but I can drag over scale. And with scale I can click here and I could choose C for hundreds, K for thousands, M for millions, B for billions, T for trillions, or the word itself, thousands, millions, billions, etc. I'm going to stick with K right here. And what will happen is this will affect the number in front of it. So now I can see it puts K after it. The value is still the regular value. If I click on this, you can see it says 506000. If I select this, you can see it still says 45500. So it remembers the actual value. It's just going to display it differently. Now let's say I had a number like 2 million, like that, and I wanted to display an M whenever the number was high enough. So I could do that. Let's edit this custom format, add a rule, and say if the value is greater than or equal to 1 million, then we're going to put the millions, the M there. And now you can see it's K for everything below a million. So 999,999, it's going to round it to a K. So what we probably want to do is actually alter that and say if it's greater than or equal to 999,500, then display it like that. So now that's K and that's M. And if we have a fractional M, you can see it shows it rounded. So let's alter it again, edit the format here, and say for millions, let's add a decimal. And let's allow, let's say, one decimal place like that. And for K, let's do the same thing. Let's allow one decimal place. And now we can see we get 45.5K and 6.5 million. Now let's say you want to show something with currency value. It's pretty easy to do this. So if, for instance, I have 100 and I want to show this in dollars, I can go to data format, say currency, and there it's $100. I can change the currency type right here, so I can change it to 100 euros. That's extra handy to do that when you have a formula result. So let me undo here so I'm at $100. And let's say I want to convert that to euros. So what I could do is say equals this amount here times, and I'll use the currency function there. Currency 1 is going to be US dollars. Currency 2 is going to be euros. And I'll stick with the default price there. So that'll actually multiply this by the currency conversion, but you can see I just get a number there. So what I'd do is go to currency for the data format and change that to euros to match the result that I know I'm going to get. Durations are another place where you may want to customize the format. For instance, if I were to type in 100H for 100 hours, you could see I get 4 days, 4 hours, but I want it to stay as hours. So what I'll do is I'll change the data format, and you can see here it's automatic, but let's go and force it to duration. And then I can set it to automatic units, and the style is either just the number and a letter like W for weeks, or the number and a word. I could go to custom units, and here I can specify exactly what I want. So I could, for instance, just say I only want hours, and then I'm going to get 100 hours there, no matter how many days or weeks it takes up. I can still change the style here to include the entire word if I want. If I wanted to include minutes all the time, I could select minutes as well, or deselect hours, and I'm always going to get the duration in minutes. Now in some situations, instead of dealing with the date as the month, day, and year, you want to deal with the day number for that year. In other words, January 1st is 1 and December 31st is 365. You can do that with a data format, but not under the date and time section here. This is just going to give you different ways to show the month, day, year. But if you go to create custom format and you switch the type to date and time, it should be there automatically because it recognizes this is the date. Then you could set this to day and year. And let's go and remove the month and the day here and get rid of the comma here at the beginning too. And instead add day of year. So let's put it afterwards. And in between it, let's put something like a dash. And now you can see this is the 171st day of 2021. And if I set all of this to day and year, I can type a regular date. Like let's say July 1st, 2021. And the formatting is going to change that to 182. The actual is the date and time at midnight like that. But what's displayed is going to be in the format that we want. I could edit the custom format maybe and change it to something like year colon space and then a space and day colon like that. And you could see it changes the format to look like that. So you have a lot of different options here. Sometimes you have just text like this and you want to format in a special way, like maybe add parentheses around it or something like that. So you could do that in create custom format as well. Let's put this one called brackets around text. The type is text, of course. There's nothing you can really do to this, but you can go and put square brackets around it, put something before it and after it, you know, like name, colon, that kind of thing. You can see the example here. Let's just do the square brackets. And you can see I've added that. Let's add that to the entire column here. So brackets around text. And now whatever I type in here gets those square brackets around it. You can see the actual value doesn't have those. It's just how we view it. Now you can convert between bases. One example of this is to convert a decimal number to a hexadecimal value. So for instance, if I wanted to do colors here, I might have red, green, and blue. I may have, say, you know, 127, 127, 63 as the values here. And I can get the actual color number by taking this, multiplying it by 2 to the power of 16 plus this times 2 to the power of 8 plus this multiplied by nothing. And that's the actual color number. But normally you wouldn't see it in decimal. You would see it in hexadecimal. That's how you work with colors if you're doing HTML development or app development or anything like that. So you would want to represent this as hexadecimal. You can go to data format and select numeric system. And here you can change it to base 16 and it will show you the base 16 version of this. You can even set it to the number of places. So in this case, I want it to always be 6. So this is the result here. If I were to say do 0 and then 255 and then 255, you can see that's the value for that color. So I've got one bonus one for you. Now sometimes you may want to use fractions instead of decimal numbers, like for instance measuring pieces of wood or lengths of rope. Sometimes it makes sense to show halves or quarters. So in this case, let's select all the cells here and I could go and just select fraction and you could see I get fractional values there. I could set the accuracy. So I could set it up to 1 digit, 7/8, 2 digits, 23, 24ths, etc. I can do halves, quarters, eighths and force it into that. I could also do a custom format and move the decimal there and then under decimal I can say fractions instead. And for fractions I can set those same values here. So let's have it go up to 1 digit like that, up to eighths. And then here I can add something additional. So for instance, if this is inches, I could do IN like that. So there's a look at a whole bunch of different ways to use cell formatting and custom cell formatting to get things done in numbers. You can alter these techniques to fit your needs, combine some of the ideas as well, and hopefully it'll help you make your spreadsheets that much better. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.